in the state versus George Zimmerman. We will be hearing more from the lead investigator who interrogated George Zimmerman after Trayvon Martin was shot and killed.
As the second week of testimony began, the jury also heard George Zimmerman in his own words. The prosecution played audio and video interviews of him detailing his self-defense argument to officers in the days following the shooting. He revealed Trayvon Martin's last words, and we saw how investigators challenged his story. WESH 2 Stuart Moore is live at the Seminole County Courthouse this morning to break down the testimony for us. Stuart?
Well, Jason, he obviously went through the different interrogations that he gave to George Zimmerman, one the night of the actual shooting, then another one as he walked through the neighborhood, and then even a separate one when they asked him more questions after they heard the 911 calls. During those hours of testimony, the state tried to prove the fact that George Zimmerman was skeptical, and even the investigators were skeptical of his story.
When he came up to me, he said, "You got a problem?" And I said, "No." He said, "You have a problem now," and then punched me.
For hours yesterday, jurors heard George Zimmerman in his own words tell police what happened the night he shot and killed Trayvon Martin. On the stand, the two investigators who questioned him about why he followed Trayvon and why he never told him he was with the neighborhood watch.
From our experience point, you've had two opportunities to identify yourself as somebody who was actually not being doing harm.
On the video and audio recordings, George Zimmerman tells the cops he was scared and that's why he did not say anything to the unarmed teen. Police on the tape seemed skeptical of that truth, even pointing out that he got out of his vehicle and used his own alleged volunteer work to highlight why announcing himself should not have been a problem.
He had made reference to mentoring children, specifically African American children. Why it didn't occur to him to go ahead and try to say something to somebody he was following.
And even at one point, they played an audio clip where George Zimmerman said that he was not following the teen, that he actually was just walking the same direction. That's when the investigator actually laughed on that tape, questioning that's the exact same thing. Now, coming up later on this morning, he will be back on the stand as Mark O'Meara continues his cross. The major question still out there is whether or not George Zimmerman will take the stand in his own defense now that these tapes have been played, and whether or not Trayvon Martin's mother will take the stand today. Reporting live from the Seminole County Courthouse, Stuart Moore, WESH 2 News.